Should you use Godot? Should everyone use Godot?
We will give you 10 reasons why you should. Of course, the video on why you should definitely not use Godot is on the way. You should watch it.
Number one, it is well suited for beginners, but it is also absolutely possible to make commercial games. Godot is one of the most beginner-friendly engines out there. It is used at schools, and my university uses it for game development courses. You can even do visual scripting in case you are scared of text. But you can teach a fifth grader how to use RPG Maker, you might say now. And you are right, and I have done that in the past, and it was fun. I love the RPG Maker to tiny blocky bits, but it is not the engine of choice for commercial game development, unlike Godot, which has everything you need for it.
Number two, it does not cost money. Godot is free to use, like completely. No cost to install, no revenue share, no matter how much you make. This is cool because money can be used in exchange for goods and services. It makes it indefinitely cheaper than Game Maker or RPG Maker. It even has a free dark mode, and I am specifically looking at you, my bright Unity.
Number three, GDScript, which is awesome. And you even have an integrated IDE. You can use other languages to do your scripting, and you can use other IDEs, but that does not mean you should. GDScript is so clean. Look at it. It's so shiny. It looks a bit like Python, and it's honestly my favorite scripting language ever. It is also interpreted, which means it does not need to compile. I am looking at you, Game Maker. The integrated code editor is really cool and works seamlessly with the documentation. Also, it opens about 1000 times faster than Visual Studio and does not use 110% of my laptop's RAM.
Number four, you can write C++ if you want or need to. If you are a real manly man with a beard like I-Man, you want to chop some wood and write some C++. Large parts of your codebase are not performance critical, but some games have a natural bottleneck somewhere. And for these cases, C++ can save the day with its low overhead. GD Native gives you an easy way to get the best of both worlds. Scripting the majority of your code with an easy-to-write language and doing the rest in C++ if you cannot prevent it. You can also add modules into the engine if you are so manly that you even dare recompiling the engine.
Number 5. You can use Godot on a toaster and even a Chromebook. The engine itself is so small and does use so little resources, it's crazy. Without the demo projects, the download size is just 35 megabyte. It starts up instantly and runs everywhere. How do they do such many things with so little bit? People have used the web-based editor on a Chromebook to make games. That is how little computing power you need to make games with this engine. This is great for teaching and great for inclusivity. Honestly, even just as a guy with an older laptop, I am happy this engine performs so well.
Number 6. It is open source. This is pretty awesome if you like to read well-structured code before going to bed. And even if you don't, you can refer back to it when some behavior is unclear. Also, you can fix stuff that bothers you and make a pull request, or profit from other people putting in the hours.
Number 7. It has an awesome community. You guys are awesome and I consider marrying all of you. It is not the largest community yet, but there are just so many nice people. Every day there are more tutorials and plugins coming up. The community is generally very open to sharing stuff they made.
Number 8. It has insane tools for productivity and reuse. The system of scenes and nodes is really helpful once you get behind it. You can make a scene, put it into scenes, and put these into scenes. If you make the scene self-sufficient, you can instantiate it wherever you need it. Also, there are many powerful nodes, like the animation player, which can animate almost anything. A lot of features can be implemented easily just by combining the right nodes and a little bit of code to glue them together.
Number 9. The great UI and great UI nodes. Godot's UI is just so clean and nice, and I love it, okay? And somehow its UI is made with the same functionality you can use in the editor as UI nodes, which is crazy. The UI nodes themselves are super powerful. By far the easiest way I have seen to make a top-notch UI without working too much.
Number 10. Godot is the king of 2D that can also do 3D. Simply using your 3D physics for a 2D game does work, but it is a hassle. Godot made a cool decision and separated those two, which made working in 2D so nice. All vectors are 2D, everything is easy to get pixel perfect, it is nice. But once 2D just feels flat to you, it is easy to switch to 3D or even combine those two.
So this is why you should use Godot. Stay tuned for the reasons why you really shouldn't. If you want to see this channel succeed, help us out by pushing the like button. Oh, and we make videos every week, sometimes about our colorful action roguelike that you guys named First Fast Fungeon. Maybe go check it out.